Welcome to a lesson on multiplication and division involving zero. I'd like to start by talking about what we already know about multiplication. Multiplication of natural numbers can be viewed as repeated addition. For example, if we have 3 times 5, this means we have 3 groups of 5, which can be modeled using this diagram here or by repeated addition. Either way, the product would be 15. Next, the commutative property states that when 2 numbers are being multiplied together, the product is the same regardless of the order. So 3 times 5 or 5 times 3 is equal to 15. So now let's talk about multiplication involving 0. For any real number a, 0 times a equals a times 0, which always equals 0. So the product of 0 in any real number is always 0. So 0 times 3 is equal to 0. 0 times negative 5 is equal to 0. 6 times 0 is equal to 0. And negative 8 times 0 is equal to 0. Now to try to justify this, remember 0 times 3 means we have 0 groups of 3. Well, if we have 0 groups of something, of course we would have to have 0 items. And then if we change the order of the multiplication and consider 6 times 0, this means we have 6 groups of 0. Well, if each group contains 0, we would still have a total of 0 items. Therefore, 6 times 0 is equal to 0. Now let's talk about division involving 0. For any real number a, 0 divided by a is equal to 0. But a divided by 0 is undefined. So division by 0 is undefined. And the only special case here is that a cannot equal 0, meaning we can't have 0 over 0, or 0 divided by 0. So let's take a look at 2 examples. Here we have 0 divided by 2, which is equal to 0, but 2 divided by 0 is undefined. Now let's discuss why that is. 0 divided by 2, here's a set that has 0 items in it, and I can still take this and divide it into 2 parts, but notice that both parts still contain 0 items. But if I had a set of 2 items, but it's impossible to divide these 2 items into 0 groups, therefore division by 0 is undefined. I hope you found these explanations helpful.